Do you hear that? That sweet, sweet music.
Yeah, I did that. If you think you're not skilled enough to do this kind of thing, you are so wrong. You are dead wrong. Absolutely, 100%. Absolutely. Can I say absolutely again? You're wrong! You can do it!
A Cappella update.
To make my background tracks, what I usually do is just create an 8-bar loop that can go over and over. And today, I'm going to show you how to do that. To do really quick, simple, at-home a cappella, all you need is an iPhone with GarageBand on it and one of these kinds of headphones with the microphone thing. So you go onto GarageBand, start a new song, and one of the most important things that you must decide right out of the gate is the tempo and also the key signature, those two things. Just at 100 beats per minute, okay? And then we're gonna set the key signature something exciting. We're gonna go E flat, cause that's exciting, and nobody likes to play E flat, but on a phone it's really easy. What you want to do next is to get a very simple chord progression that's very easily repeatable, and get that recorded into it so that you have something to base the rest of your parts on. Now I'm going to do this with the keyboard, but don't worry, the keyboard will not remain throughout the duration of the song. Once you've got your chord progression in, what you got to do next is start on your vocals. And we learned last week that the most important part is bass, so we're going to do that first. You got to plug in your headphone microphone thing, and we're just going to use this microphone, even though I know it's a piece of crap, but it's the best I got, and it's what I've been using, and honestly, it sounds fine. All right, bass line, here we go. Perhaps the next most important part, right behind bass, is the vocal percussion. So we're going to go ahead and record that next. Just to spice up the vocal percussion a bit, I'm going to add some hi-hats ringing in through there. See how it sounds? With just the bass and the vocal percussion, I feel like it sounds a little dry. So I'm going to try another bass-ish baritone layer, just try to fill it out a little more. To bring things up a little bit, you gotta add some higher frequencies as well. So we're gonna throw in a tenor line, really simple, just to fly over the top like a little birdie. That sounds really good. We're gonna make it sound even better by adding a harmony part to that. Having listened to it through, I feel like it needs more da-da-da-das, so we're gonna put some more da-da-da-das in there. I feel like this is missing some ah-wahs, so we're gonna put some ah-wahs in there. Last of all, we need something that's not chained to the rhythm like the rest of these. Something that's free-flowing, can kind of go wherever it wants in the chord. Like, you know, a soloist.
This one's for you, baby. To my beautiful wife.
Woke up this morning, saw your pretty face. Rolled out of bed and went to work for you. I worked so hard, trying to make ends meet. Cause I just love you more than my life. You are the one, the reason I'm still breathing. You are the thing that I see every single morning. You're the gold off in the sunset. You're the thing I want to believe when I get upset. And I said, hey, why aren't we going someplace fun? And I said, hey, I'm making these words up. And I said, hey, will you come with me? Hey, and what do you say? I love you, baby.
Boom! Just like that. Made an a cappella song. That one goes out to you, baby. See, it's so easy. And even though it's so easy, you might still prefer to listen to other people's. So I got you a playlist right there of a whole bunch of great songs that were uploaded to YouTube this week. Of course, if you missed my last week's video, right here, you can learn all about why bass is the most important. And it's great. Also, don't forget to subscribe to me and follow me on Facebook. Because that's good. So yeah, see you next week.